You might think hanging a 420-pound, 500-horsepower 4.0 liter Honka Flat 6 over the back wheels of the 2018 Porsche 911 GT3 would make it hard to handle at speed, or otherwise, you might also think adding rear wheel steering would accentuate that skittishness. You, and probably some physicists, would be wrong on both accounts. Sure, on cold tires, in the morning around a roundabout, the race red GT3 can, and will, slide its tail sideways without warning. It is still for the hardcore. But exiting a sweeper at 80 miles per hour with foot to floor, it's planted like an old oak tree, even over the shiny, red and white curbing at Circuit Guadix in southern Spain. Like we said, it is for the hardcore. The GT3 is the track car from the track car brand. It's been 18 years since the first 911 GT3 premiered, and since then, it's gone from hiding a 355 horsepower 3.6 liter flat 6 to today's 500 horsepower 911 GT3 cup derived 4.0. It's the only naturally aspirated 911 you can buy right now. Peak power is at a screaming 8,250 RPM, while all 339 pounds FT of twist are available at 6,000 RPMs. The 7-speed PDK-equipped GT3 is faster than the stick, with a sprint time of 3.2 seconds using launch control. The 6-speed manual takes 3.8 seconds. The GT3 doesn't get a 7th manual gear like the Carrera. Porsche tells us that's because the GT3 doesn't need a cruising gear. It's not for cruising. The PDK car takes 11 seconds flat to get to 124 miles per hour, which we can basically verify after hammering down narrow straight, desolate back roads near Granada terminal velocities, 197 miles per hour, PDK, 198 miles per hour, 6MT, are cheap and top gear for both. The GT3 gets redesigned front and rear bumpers made of lightweight polyurethane and carbon fiber. New front air blades force air to the brakes, and the fixed rear wing is about an inch higher, which puts it right on the horizon line when on a flat road. Unfortunately, the total package makes 20% more downforce than the outgoing model while keeping the same coefficient of drag. It's about 2 inches wider and 1 inch lower than the 911 Carrera. A straight rear diffuser hides just under the back end, cleaning airflow underneath. Porsche's active stability management system is standard and controls the damping on the McPherson strut front and multi-link rear suspension. Auxiliary springs help keep tension on the main springs and back, helping the car stay composed after rapid and complete deflection. Like when flying over the crest of a hill, the rear steering system works like similar systems from other manufacturers. It uses actuators to angle the wheels up to 1.5 degrees depending on speed. Below 31 miles per hour, the rears turn opposite the fronts. Above 50 miles per hour, they turn the same way for quick lane change maneuvers, on the track or off.